the most accurate depiction of SpaceX at Starbase. Even when there are no launches taking place, the site continues to be a vibrant hub of activity, reflecting consistent progress across a variety of systems, particularly those featuring bold and innovative designs. How all of the elements are integrating. Let's talk more about that in today's episode of NR Studio. It's true that many have expressed their disappointment about the delay of Flight 9 this month. However, it's important to remember that SpaceX efforts at Starbase go far beyond a single launch. The initiative is focused on shaping the future of space exploration. While we await the next flight, substantial progress continues to be made behind the scenes, particularly in the development of Pad B and its associated systems. A significant development in recent days has been the activity observed at Pad B. After months of eager anticipation, two large fire buckets were successfully delivered and installed in mid-April. These buckets now form the foundation of a newly developed fire trench system, which is essential for managing the extreme thrust and heat generated during a launch. With the foundation now in place, attention has turned to the orbital launch pad, which is still under development at the Sanchez site. From April 18th to April 22nd, four substantial legs for the OLM were successfully transported to Starbase. Subsequently, on April 23rd and April 2nd, these legs were installed on Pad B, characterized by their distinctive I-beam configuration and perforations at both ends. The legs demonstrate careful engineering to support substantial loads. Their dimensions and design demonstrate deliberate integration with other elements, ensuring a strong and resilient foundation for the launch mount. This modular and interchangeable methodology exemplifies SpaceX's innovative design philosophy centered on four-dimensional thinking. Now that the legs are securely in place, it is anticipated that the OLM will soon be transported to Pad B for assembly and integration. All indicators suggest that we are in the final stages of preparation, and if current momentum is maintained, the OLM could be fully operational by May. Equally important is the introduction of the support arm, a critical element of the OLM at the Sanchez site on April 22nd. This support arm, responsible for attaching the booster to the launch mount prior to ignition, is currently undergoing a significant redesign. Initial assessments indicate that each OLM could accommodate as many as 20 of these arms, suggesting a much more sophisticated and efficient quick disconnect mechanism. This modification could prove critical to improving safety protocols and launch turnaround time efficiency. Concurrently, the storage tank system on Pad B is advancing at a steady pace. In February, a large water tank was added, culminating in the recent installation of a manifold, which features a Y-shaped pipe designed to direct water from the tank to the fire trench. In the near term, we can anticipate the development of additional infrastructure to accommodate critical propellants such as liquid oxygen, liquid nitrogen, and methane. These improvements are critical to equipping Pad B for live fire evaluations and future missions. The focus at Pad B is also turning to the sump mechanism, a powerful piece of equipment designed to lift and potentially secure Starship boosters. As construction progresses on the ground, SpaceX has been diligently testing the sump to ensure its operational readiness. If Flight 9 proves successful, Flight 10 could mark the first attempt to capture a booster during its ascent. The testing is anticipated to coincide with the finalization of the OLM and the comprehensive integration of Pad B. In addition to Pad B, various sectors of Starbase are seeing significant progress. At the main launch facility, sump testing is underway. On the 22nd, the arm was raised to the top of the launch tower, then engaged in a systematic opening and closing motion. These deliberate movements are intended to evaluate the arm's flexibility and mechanical readiness, particularly in anticipation of a capture operation. The testing also serves a secondary purpose by assessing the launch tower's response to stress conditions. Early vibrations observed in both arms and towers provide important insights for SpaceX engineers as they contemplate potential reinforcements or changes. Finally, back at the production facility, efforts are ramping up on the development of the upcoming Starship prototype and its accompanying systems. New components are currently undergoing construction, assembly, and preparation for the next phase of testing and integration. While a single launch may be the highlight, it's the ongoing, iterative progress happening behind the scenes that truly drives SpaceX forward. Despite the delay of Flight 9, Starbase remains a hub of incredible activity, The journey to the stars continues to be meticulously constructed, one weld, one fire bucket, and one launch tower at a time. Progress on the Starship prototype is moving apace at Starbase, as SpaceX prepares for the upcoming series of vehicles destined for flight testing. From booster and spacecraft development to significant infrastructure upgrades, the flurry of activity in Mega Bay 1 and the surrounding facilities clearly demonstrates the rapid pace of progress being made. In conjunction with Mega Bay 1, B-14 is currently engaged in post-static fire installation and procedures. Recent observations of the enhanced hot station ring indicate some progress directed toward optimizing stage separation. Once the major upgrades are complete, B-14 will be equipped with a flight termination system before being integrated with Ship 35 for testing and the next launch attempt. Next to B-14 is B-15, which was recently returned to Mega Bay 1 from its previous location in the rocket park. It is currently undergoing checks and preparations, with widespread speculation as to its readiness for Flight 11. Similar to B-14, this phase will focus on critical systems, including installation of the Raptor engines, fin grids, and fuel tank preparation. Additionally, it is anticipated that B-16 in Mega Bay 1 will receive its engines after successfully completing cryogenic testing. Given the anticipation surrounding Flight 10, the pace for this final integration is measured, yet deliberate. Concurrently, B-17, after successfully completing its cryogenic testing in early April, has been repositioned to the rocket park. This development may clear the bay for vehicles with more pressing launch schedules, such as the highly anticipated B-18, widely considered the inaugural model of the enhanced V-2 booster series. In nearby Mega Bay 2, progress on ship development is proceeding at an impressive pace. Ship 35 has been fully outfitted with its engines and systems and is now ready to proceed to the large test facility for static fire testing. Prior to this, it is likely that S-35 underwent further evaluation following its successful cryogenic testing. S-36, which has been fully stacked since March, also indicates that it is approaching the testing phase. The PES dispenser system, a critical component for satellite deployment, has been operational for several weeks, and recent imagery shows its heat shield fully assembled, featuring a specially redesigned cover. The implementation of cryogenic testing appears to be on the horizon. Meanwhile, S-37 appears to have completed its assembly, with its cover segment delivered to Mega Bay 2 in early April. On the 22nd, the vehicle was seen in the midst of installing its heat shield, using a cover design analogous to that seen on S-36. Anticipating future developments, S-38 appears poised to be the next candidate for stacking. On the 22nd, a newly engineered PES dispenser, likely associated with S-38's payload bay, was successfully transported to Mega Bay 2. Critical elements such as the nose cone have been observed inside the Star Factory, indicating that assembly is nearing completion. Importantly, Ship 39, thought to be the inaugural Ship V3, shows signs of substantial improvement. The presence of a liquid oxygen header tank and nose cone observed inside the Star Factory indicates significant progress in airworthiness and performance, suggesting that S-39 may make its public debut in the coming weeks. Concurrently, efforts continue on Mega Bay 1 and 2 as the complete demolition of the original high bay nears its conclusion. Provided the structure survives and the adjacent Stargate has been dismantled, in place of the former structure, SpaceX will build Giga Bay, a much larger facility intended to facilitate the simultaneous production and repair of multiple Starship and Super Heavy booster rockets. This upgrade will significantly increase efficiency and facilitate faster turnaround times. A similar gigabay is also proposed for Cape Canaveral, highlighting SpaceX's dedication to improving Starship operations. This infrastructure development illustrates the company's strategic vision to facilitate frequent interplanetary launches over the long term. Given the rapid progress currently underway, SpaceX has its sights set on a number of bold goals for the near term. The start of operations is marked by Flight 9, anticipated to be the maiden launch of the enhanced Starship 5-2. This mission is particularly noteworthy given the substantial challenges faced during the last two consecutive test flights. In its pursuit of Flight 9, SpaceX aspires not only to demonstrate improved performance, but also to achieve a successful maiden recovery of the Super Heavy booster, a critical step toward achieving full reusability. The arrangements for this flight have been carefully and systematically considered, While the delays can be frustrating, they highlight the company's commitment to prioritizing success. This effort is more than a single assessment. It builds a foundation for future development. If Flight 9 achieves its goal, the next major milestone will be Flight 10, which could potentially represent the first attempt to capture a returning Starship using a blowpipe system. Mastering this technique will be a key goal for future launches, as it is critical to ensuring the rapid and reliable reuse of both stages. Space is gearing up for one of its most technically challenging endeavors yet, in-orbit refueling. This capability is critical for space missions, particularly NASA Artemis III lunar landing, scheduled for mid-2027. The success of that mission will depend on the infrastructure at SpaceX Florida Launch Facility, which includes a dedicated launch tower, an orbital launch pad, and Gigabay. These systems are currently under development and will play a critical role in facilitating crewed missions to the moon. Digging deeper, Musk has articulated an ambitious vision for Mars exploration. The first uncrewed mission is expected to occur as early as 2026, with subsequent crewed missions projected to occur between 2029 and 2031. In an unexpected development, Musk has articulated an ambitious new goal: deploying Tesla's Optimus robot to Mars by the end of 2025, further advancing an already bold roadmap. In pursuit of this ambitious goal, SpaceX aims to achieve an extraordinary launch cadence with a target of 400 missions over the next 4 years. This equates to about 100 launches per year, or about one launch every 3 days. Achieving such an accelerated tempo requires a harmonious combination of launch operations, substantial production capacity, and fully reusable spacecraft. In conclusion, SpaceX is entering one of the most critical times in its history. The dynamic progress at Starbase, fueled by cutting-edge manufacturing, infrastructure improvements, and prototype readiness, paints a picture of a company poised for a new chapter in space exploration. Despite ongoing challenges, SpaceX has demonstrated a storied history of innovation and resilience in the face of adversity. Through continued dedication and inventive strategies, they are progressively charting a course toward a future where space travel becomes faster, more economical, and more common. Let's turn our attention to our closing topic, which highlights one of SpaceX's upcoming endeavors: the upcoming Dragon cargo resupply mission to the International Space Station. Dubbed CRS-32, the mission is set to launch aboard a Falcon 9 rocket on April 21st at approximately 12:15 a.m. Eastern Time, originating from Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center. The effort, a collaboration between SpaceX and NASA, is intended to transport several tons of vital supplies and scientific equipment to facilitate ongoing activities aboard the International Space Station. As outlined in NASA Mission Summary, the Dragon spacecraft will not only carry supplies and general logistics materials, but also other essential items. It will also provide a variety of innovative scientific payloads. These include a demonstration of the station's free-floating robotic assistance enhanced maneuverability. Another important enhancement is a sophisticated air quality monitoring system, which could prove essential for future missions to the Moon and Mars, in a context where environmental regulations are critical. Furthermore, Dragon will carry two atomic clocks engineered to investigate the effects of space on timekeeping, advancing research in relativity, and highly precise global time synchronization. After more than a month of docking at the International Space Station, the Dragon spacecraft will lift off and begin its journey back to Earth. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next video, and thank you all for your support.